searching for that demon, get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave.
Watch it, booty.
Calm down.
I would have been in trouble too.
Yeah.
Why? Why I'm in trouble?
I'm telling you right now.
Because I'm making her dance. I'm mad she'd be busting out in splits.
That's her favorite thing.
You don't remember doing splits when you was a little girl? When you was a little girl, you was flexible, like six. You was flexible.
Yeah.
You weren't doing no fucking
flex. Remember that stage.
You don't remember that stage of your life. What was you doing? What's wrong with you?
Me?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Baby's always trying to do what the parents do. She be trying to copy, 100% copy. That's what they do. Keep him going under. bag. Stop. No, do not touch that.
To the Midwest and Northeast. What a perfect time to be in the Sunshine State as we welcome you to TIAA Bank Field in Jacksonville, Florida. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Indianapolis Colts and the Jacksonville Jaguars. Football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. The first carry now for Tony Pollard. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down. Second and 10
at the 25-yard line.
Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete.
I don't see Marvin trying to get him the football out of the backfield. They love what he can do in open space, and they believe that he creates mismatches they can exploit.
Complete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So instead of fourth down, first down.
Well, so much for winning the down you put a lot of emphasis on, because third down is key for offense and defense. Instead, you're going to stay on the field and start a new set of downs.
Throwing right, and that's complete. And down inside the 15 he goes. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards.
First and 10 at the 13-yard line.
They'll look to throw here on first down. This will be caught at about the 5. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
It's a gain of 9.
These are his numbers from last week's contest.
6
catches, 53 yards.
And I'd certainly expect them to use him quite a bit, because he runs excellent routes, has good hands, and knows how to get open.
Intended. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it. They tried to throw on second down, unsuccessful. Now it's 3rd and 1. And that is caught. Touchdown, Jacksonville. DJ Chark. So now this offense will take over, and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And he will bring it back. And interception return for a Colts TD. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. After the pick six, they go right back to the air. And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course. An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25.
Coverage on the play by Trayvon Diggs.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off near the 29. And the return will stop right around the 25.
Intercepted by the Colts.
This offense ready to head back out there as they'll take over with a little over a minute to play in this first quarter. They'll run with Pollard to begin the drive. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Trying to
Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. They still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give them the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy. And that's what they're doing early in this game.
34-yard line.
We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you got to play the long game. Keep handing it to them, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn them to 6, 7, 8, and maybe more later on.
And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to convert on third and short yardage with a gain of 4. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. After 1:17:7, the score on EA Sports.
Jaguars 7.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Manny?
And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. He's picked off at his own 46. And he will bring it back. An interception return for a Colts TD. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. The Colts are going to get him. Down he goes.
The quarterback sack.
2 sacks last week. Another one right here. He's been unblockable lately, and I think that goes all the way back to not just his offseason, but the film study he's been doing during the week, because I think he's found matchups that he likes, and he's capitalizing.
And a few times he's even defeated double teams. He doesn't care at this point. And boy, that one drops incomplete, but if he was hit a fraction sooner, it may have been a fumble. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Incomplete, but a penalty flag is down in the backfield. Let's get the call. So instead of giving them another third down, they'll decline it, brings up 4.
Now that's smart football right there. You don't even have to really spend a lot of time considering.
Call your friends, let's get drunk.
get set to take over. They'll come out throwing here on first down. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of four. They'll contain him to just four, second down.
At the 29-yard line.
And he'll be brought down by the Colts.
Taken down and sacked.
You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You talk about some terrific athletes who are trying to put them on the ground.
They do get nine, but it leads to fourth down. He was out there waving his arms. When you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting the route, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
So the offense set to take the field here as they have the football in the final minute of this first quarter. Now a throw with a middle, and he's got it to start the drive. And the result here, a pickup of eight, leaves him with two to go on second down. Here's a second and two now from the 33.
Brings up second and two at the 33-yard line.
He'll let this one go deep for Chark. This is caught at the 20. And he'll be taken down, but first he gets deep into Indianapolis territory. 10-0 to score after one on EA Sports. And he'll get 7 yards from the 17 to the 10 before he's taken down.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
And he'll maybe get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. A bullet throw, but incomplete. So now fourth down looming. Remember, these guys went for it on their last drive, but it didn't work out.
Yeah, even though it didn't.
Get set to take over. And they'll run the option to start the drive. Hit from behind, and he's going to be driven down.
The quarterback sack.
Well, someone's been up to the task so far in this game. They are already up a couple of scores, Brandon, and guess what? I'm just going to pin their ears back now and get upfield and get after the quarterback.
It's been such an impressive first half to get that lead. Going right side here, and that's complete. Give him 14 on that one, and a first down.
First and 10 at the 37-yard line.
Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder coming up just a few minutes from now, we'll send you to Jonathan Coachman and our crew in Orlando. Coach will have a look back at some of the stats and scores from yesterday's action. Second and 11. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be taken down at the 46-yard line.
Complete.
They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Brings up third and one.
The play action fake. They'll look to throw. And this is going to be incomplete. The passing game not in sync here early. And now it's fourth down. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0 for 3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. A big roll of the dice on fourth and one, but it pays off. They convert. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. Play fake as they set up to throw. Looking left side is complete. He's got him. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good gain again. That's now 31 yards combined on those last two plays.
That's a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field.
And he's under pressure and he'll go down. Back at the 26-yard line. Now the Jags will use the second of their timeouts. As the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime. Sacks, a growing theme in this first half. This is second and long. That one complete. He finds Sharp. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. The Jaguars now will use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. They'll look to throw for it on 3rd and 1. His pass caught at the 4. And the Jaguars are going to have a 1st and goal coming up as they find a way to convert there on 3rd and 1. They'll go again from the 3 here on 2nd and goal. They'll throw now on the final play. Got his man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jaguars. They'll have the football to start the third quarter. So the drive's going to start with Pollard. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Given 13 yards on the opening play of the drive and also given the first down. That one definitely helps as they try to push the ball down the field here, trailing early in the third quarter.
And even though they're trailing, not abandoning the running game. People may call it an adjustment. I think it's just much more sticking to what works for you and continuing to have faith in it. And the running game is starting to pay off.
Taken down.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
Brings up 2nd and 5.
And now the throw taken in by Chart. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line. It's a first down, his 4th catch of the game after having 3 in the first half.
1st and 10 at the 40-yard line.
Target. And now it's 2nd down.
At the 40-yard line.
The Colts are going to get him. Down he goes.
The quarterback sack.
And that takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, doesn't it?
Now they're looking at a 3rd and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mo is a very, very fickle man.
Out of the gun now. 3rd down. The open man is Shark, it's complete. And he is going to have a Jags first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Third and 19, no problem as they're able to convert.
And at the 25-yard line.
On first down, he'll drop to throw. On the slant, this is Shark. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. This duo locked in, 14 yards there, and a first down.
That's good for another Jacksonville first and 10 at the 11-yard line.
And now Chenault on the end around. And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
Chenault, the ball
5 carry. Yards is the tally on the first down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
A gain of 5 brings up 2nd and 5.
That's complete right around the 8. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. It'll go down as a 2-yard loss, and it brings up a 3rd down. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar them. It'll be a 1st and 10 coming up as this offense takes over possession of the football in the 3rd quarter. They'll try and start this drive in the air. Eluding the pressure right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And too much juice. It'll be out of bounds, incomplete. 3rd quarter on a Monday night with a 2nd and 10 coming up. Now a shotgun handoff to Pollard. And he's going to take this one across midfield and into Colts territory. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
And he will have a Jaguars first down as they're able to convert on 3rd and short yardage with a gain of 4. It's a gain of 4, and it gets him the first.
1st and 10 at the 44-yard line.
They run the option here on 1st and 10. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be 2nd down. Decided to hand it off that time on the run-pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice, steady game.
On 2nd down, it's Pollard. And little room to maneuver there. He gets it down about the 39. They follow up the gain of 5 by only getting 1 there on 2nd down. From the Colts, an extra defensive back in there now on 3rd down. Now back to throw. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. So here we go. The offense is going to stay out there. They're going for it on 4th and 8. And that is going to do it for this 3rd quarter of action. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. He was called on 3 times in the win last week as his first one here's away. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. After an excellent punt, this offense in a tough spot down inside their own 5. A little bit of space there for the first down run, as that's going to get him about 5 yards. Down on the field, we've got an injured Colt after that last play. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. On 2nd down now, Pollard. And they'll bring him down right around the 13. I tell you, they didn't give it to him much through the first 3 quarters, but when they have, he's been efficient. Maybe they ride him more here down the stretch.
I'm not sure it was actually in the game plan for him to have as few carries as he has, but it might play out really well.
Oh, now he's stripped. He lost the football. And the Colts pick it up, and they are going to score on the fumble return. Touchdown. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. traffic there. That's complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
Gain of eight brings up second and two at the 33 yard line.
Connection made with Chenault. And he'll bring it up here to right as the 40-yard line. Correct me if I'm wrong. You know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Intended for number 82. Incomplete. Brings up second and 10 at the 40-yard line.
So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Buying time to his left. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. The Jaguars on third down. They've converted three times and eight chances. This is third and 10. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he's unable to haul it in. So it falls incomplete over the middle third of the field. And that brings up fourth.
It's now.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Now a pass hauled in downfield. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Jacksonville. DJ Chark. With touchdown number 12 on the year. After a good punt, this offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. Back to throw now on first down. This is Chenault on the receiving end. And he gets this one just shy of the 35 to the 34. A very solid gain of 27. And with that last play, he's now up over that 300-yard mark.
And in today's NFL, it almost feels routine. And I hate that when you talk about a 300-yard passing game. To me, 300 yards still signifies excellence, and he's achieved that in this performance.
He'll get about four as he's past the 35 to the 38-yard line. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six.
Second and six.
Now whistles here, and I believe one of the Jaguar linemen might have moved. That's going to set him back 5 yards. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. They'll look to throw. Throw left side, going to be caught by Chenault. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 70th catch for him on the year. Like so many others, this goes for a first down. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Jaguar football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. He's going to let it fly. And a flag comes in as that one falls incomplete. Well, let's see who this is on. So the defense helping him out a little bit here late in the fourth.
You'll take a little help from the other guys, won't you?
On play action, they'll throw. Rolling to his right. to the goal line, but it's incomplete. I see you nodding your head up and down. It's a very heady decision at this stage of the game. Out of the pocket, nowhere to go. Just get rid of it.
That's a smart play because you're not worried about your completion percentage, and you're also not trying to force it into bad traffic as well. Throw the ball away, live to fight another down.
And he will maneuver his way down about the 7. Only a couple yards there, and that's going to set up a long 3rd and goal.
Brings up 3rd and goal.
They'll look to throw. The quick slant caught. And we'll get this into the end zone for a Jaguar touchdown. So this offense will head back out there, already in excellent field position thanks to the interception. They'll go with Pollard here on 1st down. And he'll get this down to about the 30-31 yard line. Now a timeout called for by the defense as the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play. Gonna run again here with Pollard. And he's gonna have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. Now the Colts gonna burn the 2nd of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 33 seconds remaining. An important play right here, 3rd and 10.
And I would expect pressure here.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. Flushed out right. He may try and run for this. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. 5 yards that time out of the scramble. But now they're looking at a 4th down situation.
I like his thought process and his...